Hi everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And if you're like me, you've probably heard the term essential oils. I know I have, and it's always been kind of a mystery to me as to what they are and why would I want to use them, and if I did use them, what would they help with? Now, we're not here to promote a product or claim that it has benefits that are beyond anything that you might ever hear of. But we thought it would be helpful to bring in somebody that knows more than we do and discuss what essential oils are. And that's why we invited our niece, Gwen DeHaan, because she has been using them now for over a year and she knows far more than we do. And she's going to help us demystify what they are and why I would want to even include that. So I know that lemons have oil in them. I've heard the word lemon oil. I know people use it on their furniture. How do they go about getting oil out of a lemon? I know if I cut a lemon, I'm just getting the juice.
Mm-hmm. So an essential oil from any citrus fruit, really, comes from the peel. So if you've ever opened a citrus fruit and you saw that burst from the peel, that's the essential oil of a lemon. They cold press their citrus fruits.
Okay.
And the rest of the oils that they have are steam distilled.
Okay. And I remember when we were in California, we saw an oil press mm-hmm. where they just took the big the oil from the olives by pressing it and getting all that wonderful oil out of them.
Mm-hmm.
So what made you get interested in essential oils?
Well, I have two kids, obviously you know that. One is 2 and the other one is almost 5. And last winter we were sick with everything and anything. And I wanted to find a more natural option to help keep my kids healthy. I wanted to help boost their immune system. I felt like a helpless mom who couldn't do anything for
her
kids.
Especially once they start going to nursery school or kindergarten.
And I wanted to find something. So I called up my friend who has 5 kids who swore by these and that they helped tremendously. So I thought, what could hurt, really? So I bought some essential oils and we have been blessed ever since using them.
Well, that's good.
And they've been really helpful.
Where were you when I was raising my children?
Right.
And they were sick every week.
Yes, so I am so happy I found them. We use one called their Protective Blend. It is great to help support immune systems. I put it in the diffuser, which is misting over here.
Oh yes, it smells wonderful.
It is just a great way to help any threats that are floating around in the air or any threats that are in our bodies.
What kind of oil might be in that one?
There's cinnamon oil.
Cinnamon.
There's clove in there, eucalyptus and rosemary, and it just reminds me of Christmas.
Great. It smells.
Smells delicious over here.
Yeah.
Very good.
Mm-hmm.
And how do you use that with your kids? Because I can't see a 2-year-old standing still for very long.
Right. So I have little already made roller bottles that have coconut oil in them.
Okay.
And you just rub it right on their feet.
On their feet?
And you put it on their feet because they have a lot of large pores on the bottom of your feet.
Oh.
So it gets into your bloodstream really fast.
What did you do to me last night?
Without even knowing that.
Yeah.
You were having problems with your muscles in your neck, so I rubbed some peppermint oil that I had on your neck, and that felt so good that mm-hmm. you said, why don't you put some on my feet?
Yeah.
Which I did, and you slept like a baby.
And don't I smell good now?
It did make you smell better.
Mm-hmm.
So if I wanted to use these on like a little child mm-hmm. or myself, and they're so powerful, you know, are there any cautions?
You want to use a type of carrier oil. So this is called fractionated coconut oil.
Okay.
So that fat molecule is taken out so it stays in a liquid form.
Oh, so it's not greasy feeling.
Right. So you can use this. This will make your oils last longer. It helps cover a larger area.
Oh, that makes sense.
It dilutes your oils so they're not so potent. So if you would put it on sensitive skin, elderly skin, a baby, or on a sensitive area,
yeah,
it would help lessen the intensity of it.
Okay.
So you can feel it if you'd like.
It
absorbs pretty quickly. But really, you can use any type of vegetable-based oil. I mean, you could use almond oil, jojoba oil, avocado oil, grapeseed oil. I mean, if you really needed one right away,
yeah,
you could use a vegetable oil if you wanted to. But yeah, it absorbs in pretty quickly.
Nice.
And yeah, you could kind of use it as a lotion if you wanted to.
My, you look like you have softer, marble hands. Look at that.
My garden hands are being recovered.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It'll help cover a larger area, really, if, you know.
Now, would you ever put the oil on and then put, like, gloves over it to help intensify, like, overnight? I don't think you have to do it, but...
You wouldn't have to. No. I mean, if you wanted to, you know, have softer hands and go to bed with it, yeah, you could do that. You can kind of make it a little in more intense if you put, like, a heating pad on,
mm-hmm.
and it kind of drives the oil in.
Sure. That makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you use it on yourself, obviously, and you use mm-hmm. them on your children. Does mm-hmm. your husband buy into
does.
That?
He does. At first, you know, he was probably my biggest skeptic.
Yes.
And then all of a sudden, I'll notice one will be moved.
Oh.
One will be over by his stuff. And I think, oh, you do believe. But yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes. So if I were interested in getting oils like this, can I buy them at the grocery store? I mean, I see some things at the grocery store, but, you know, what's the difference between these and those?
Well, the essential oil industry really has no governing body watching over and making sure what is in the oils at a store is actually in the bottle. So it could say 100% pure essential oil, but it might not be really pure. Only a small percentage of an essential oil really has to be in the bottle, and the rest can be some type of carrier oil or a filler so that they can sell it at a cheaper price. So the company I use, they didn't like that, so they wanted to set a high standard for themselves and make sure that all their oils were pure 100% essential oils. And they third-party test all their oils with five independent labs.
Wow.
So they can't, you know,
right,
mess up their own things, or their test results. Their tests are very extensive and very expensive, and they test for purity and potency because they want to make sure their oils are the best and they're going to do what we want them to do for our bodies.
Right. And is it a continual thing? I mean, they don't just do it once and then
nope,
never again?
Nope. They test every single bottle.
Wow.
Every single batch, yep.
That's impressive.
Mm-hmm.
Well, obviously, in our Wisconsin garden, we have found that certain plants work really well as companions to other plants because of the odors and the fragrance that they give off. Like, I use dill to put in with my squash plants to keep the squash borer and the squash bugs away from my squashes, and it has worked for 3 years in a row, so I hope it still does. And I know that people would often grow peppermint in their gardens because they like the smell of it, and they would like take a few leaves and chew on them.
Mm-hmm.
So is that more powerful than the oil, or is the oil more powerful?
Well, the oil is actually very potent. So they're 50 to 70 times more powerful than dried herbs.
Oh, my.
So as an example, there's my peppermint. So peppermint is one of their most potent ones. So one drop of peppermint oil is equal to 28 cups of peppermint tea.
28?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
So they're very, very strong. So you don't need a lot.
No.
So I'll let you sample it if you'd like.
Okay.
So we're going to put one drop in my hand. Oh,
all right.
Two. We'll put one in yours. Come on. There we go. And now take your hands and try to avoid your fingertips and rub your palms together. And then you're going to close your eyes and cup your nose. and just taking a deep breath. And it really, you can feel it in your sinuses.
It does.
You can feel it in your lungs.
A warmth going right up in.
It's a good energizing.
Oh, yes, it is.
Oil. And then you can rub it on the back of your neck.
All right.
For a nice cooling effect for a little while.
Oh, you did mention that with your feet last night when I put peppermint on your feet that it made it cool. Wow.
Yes, isn't that smoking?
Now, how long, if I didn't wash my hands, how long would this stand?
It'll absorb into your skin, but it'll be on there for a little while. So okay. I recommend washing your hands just so you don't, you know, touch your eyes later.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it'll be on it's, there for yeah. a little while, but it just smells so refreshing.
It does. There's my sinuses right up.
Yes, yes.
And I needed that today. So if I were going to use essential oils, which ones might you recommend? Which ones have you used that you have enjoyed beyond the immunity
principles? We use peppermint a lot.
I bet the kids like peppermint.
Yes, it smells good. We put it in the diffuser a lot in the morning just to help get us going.
Yeah.
I like lemon a lot. This one is a good one. You can smell it if you'd like.
I will.
It just smells so refreshing.
Oh, it does.
It's a great immune or
it smells better
mood
than
booster.
A lemon.
Mm-hmm.
Now, is this also something you could put in a drink?
Correct. Yes. You can.
Oh,
there's three ways to use essential oils. One would be aromatically, so that would be putting it in a diffuser.
Okay.
And that is just a good way for everyone in the room to experience the oils. It helps cleanse the air. It also helps elevate your mood.
Mm-hmm.
You can use it that way. And then topically would be another way. So wherever, you can put it on your hands. You can put it on the bottom of your feet because you have large pores on the bottom of your feet. So it gets into your bloodstream really fast. Or wherever on your body that you need some support. And you can also take it internally. So you can put it in...
So I could make my own tea.
Yes, you could make your own tea. You could make your own peppermint tea.
Yes.
Just put one drop in there and... Or
wow.
Not even one drop.
Yeah, that would be
just take a
powerful.
Toothpick and kind of...
Oh, really? That is that powerful?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Just dip a toothpick in and then swirl it?
Yeah, made chili with oregano and cumin. I made lemon zucchini bread with my lemon.
Wow.
What else did I make?
You could do your zucchini candy.
I could have used that in there. Oh, that would even add that more lemony flavor, which I like, really.
I put it in my water. I put lemon in my water. It just makes it taste good.
You said you put it in your water?
Correct.
Now, that cup there is what, maybe about 12 ounces or so?
Probably 12 to...
Okay, so as an example, how many drops would you actually put in,
maybe one to two.
One or two.
That's it.
That's it.
Wow.
Yep. And it helps support your kidney function and your bladder function. Just helps the body.
I would think it would kind of protect you against people sneezing all over you.
Yeah, it's a good also immune booster.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Just make sure if you ever would put it in. That it's glass or stainless steel, or you could put it in a ceramic mug.
Okay.
You could put cinnamon in your coffee if you ever wanted to do that.
Yeah, that would be good.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
What happens if you put it in plastic?
It can actually kind of act like a solvent and break down the plastic, it puts it in your water,
good
and then you're taking
drinking
plastic toxins.
That's good. Okay.
That's
very good to know. I never would have thought of that.
Well, it is amazing how much we eat, breathe, and experience all kinds of junk in the air.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I read some report about how many pounds of dirt we eat in our lifetime.
Some of it.
Some of it, yeah.
But I'm just looking at this, and you call this a diffuser?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that is absolutely delicious. I mean, the minute you put that on, I could smell it throughout the entire room. And I'm sure it's filtrating throughout the entire house. Now, does something like this cover a certain amount of space or square footage?
This one, I believe, is 600 square feet.
Okay.
There's smaller ones that cover 300 that are for a bedroom.
Bedroom, yeah.
Yeah. Gotcha. But, you know, if you think about, you know, you get air fresheners or those plug-in things, right. or those are all synthetic toxins.
Right. Yeah.
And, you know, you walk through a perfume area at a department store and you get a headache or you feel that nauseous feeling.
Yes.
Well, those are all synthetic toxins that are going in your body, and your body's really rejecting it and, you know, making you sick to tell you, get out of there, you know.
Right.
Hurry up. And with this, you can, you know, just put it in your air and have at least health benefits from it, and it's not synthetic.
Right. And it's in the water, so that it's adding moisture to the air, which is good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we use it a lot in my daughter's room because we have a pellet stove in the basement, so it really dries the air out, and this helps put that moisture in the air so she doesn't have a hard time breathing at night.
Yeah, well, and that would keep her healthier because her nasal passages wouldn't be dry.
Right. Oh, yeah.
So how many essential oils would you estimate there are currently available to people if they're interested in... I mean, are we talking about hundreds?
Well,
thousands?
There are. I think the company I get them from maybe has 100? I'm guessing. I'm not... Don't quote me on it.
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure, but...
Well, I know in the books that Lynn has looked at and done her research in. I mean, there really is quite a background information essential oils. There's a lot of information out there.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, there's a lot.
I mean, people have obviously used them forever because you hear of the Christmas story and they brought frankincense and myrrh.
There it is, right here.
So,
the king of oils.
The king of oils.
Say.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Let me smell this one.
I'm still trying to find champaka.
Well, if they ever get it, I'll let you know.
Very interesting.
But that was probably one of my favorites.
Which one is that now?
That's frankincense.
Frankincense. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
Yep.
Do you have any myrrh?
I do. It's not here, but I do.
Oh, okay.
And it's a very kind of thick consistency.
Oh, it's...
I have a dropper on it.
Oh, come in different...
Yeah, some of them are really thin, and then other ones are thicker.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, speaking of that, I know that you have some bottles here now. Are those like drops that you just shake out as opposed to using a dropper?
Well, none of them really come with droppers. I've personally bought them because they're so thick that it's hard to get it out. Or you sit there for hours, I mean, waiting for it to drop out of your hand. But, yeah, all you do is there's a little orifice on the top, and then you take it, and then it just drops out.
Yeah, one drop at a
time. You want,
well, and seeing as they're so powerful, it's probably good.
Right,
you don't
want to use
one at a time.
Yeah. And sometimes when you apply them onto your skin, because they're so potent, and if you're going to have putting it on little kids, or if you have super sensitive skin, which thank our family we do.
Yes, it's in the genes.
Yes.
If you don't mind, I'd like to put a little scrolling email address for you so that anybody who has a question about essential oils, they can contact the expert.
Yes, definitely.
That would be helpful because there's so many different kinds and it would be interesting to try them. And I know you had sent me a little sample of a couple just so I could see what they smelled like and
what
they did. So that was very helpful.
Yeah.
And fun.
Right.
Now I know I can eat them.
Yes, yes.
Very good.
Well, I think it's important that you pointed out a very good question is, yes, there are cheap versions of everything in life, and then there are quality. And it depends on what a person really wants to be exposed to. Mm-hmm. So you do get what you pay for.
Right. And a lot of people have, you know, bought store versions and thought, these aren't working, they're not doing what I want them to do. Well, it's because, you know, they might not be pure.
Right.
And then you try a pure one and you go,
it's definitely different.
Yeah,
right.
You can totally notice
the difference. Well, even just the potency. If they're putting one drop in carrier oil and essential oil is like 100%.
Right.
Makes a total difference.
Definitely.
Well, I think we're going to have to grow oil in our garden this year.
I don't think we can grow oil, Richard.
You can grow the plants.
Yes, we'll grow the plants. Mm-hmm.
That sounds good.
If you've enjoyed this video and you've learned something, please give us a thumbs up. And we'd love to hear your comments or questions, which you can direct to Gwen. And if you'd like to join our garden family, please subscribe. Thanks for watching. And
Thank
we
you.
Will just... continue to play with the oils.
Ah, yes. I will breathe deeply. May the force be with me.
Connect with us on YouTube.